A new space age has started, where private companies such as SpaceX and Rocket Lab are becoming superior power in space transportation. And other private firms such as Relativity Space and Blue Origin are planning to dominate the space market soon, by leaving government space organizations behind. So, space agencies of China and Russia are announcing their plans to compete with these companies, and the most specific company is Elon Musk's SpaceX. Both Russia's Roscosmos and China's CNS, or the China National Space Administration, announced their insane plans to build nuclear-power spacecraft, which will be faster and more efficient than the current chemical rockets. Russia was planning to start flight testing a nuclear space spacecraft called Zeus before 2030, and with a view to even actually sending it to Mars and other planets such as Jupiter by 2030. According to state-owned news agency TASS, the mission of the uncrewed transport and energy module, dubbed Zeus, will last for about 15 months. Together with the Russian Academy of Sciences, we are now making calculations about this flight's ballistics and payload, Roscosmos Executive Director for Long-Term Programs and Science, Alexander Bloshenko told reporters, as quoted by the outlet. Bloshenko detailed Zeus' ambitious journey during his remarks. First, the space tug will first fly to the moon, where it will release a spacecraft that will go on to Venus. Then it will use Venus as a gravity assist to deliver yet another spacecraft, which will make its own long journey to Jupiter. With existing technologies, a round trip to Mars could take more than 3 years. A nuclear-powered spacecraft could cut that time to just 2 years, according to NASA. Roscosmos has also signed a contract with design bureau Arsenal last year to develop a separate nuclear-powered space tug called Nuklon, according to TASS. The delivery date of the project is July 2024 and will reportedly cost more than $56.7 million. Now, the new proposal states that a reactor could be delivered to Mars aboard the Zeus space tug, where it would enter the red planet's surface and then land using a parachute system. Once activated, it could provide power to a Russian Mars base that would act as a habitat for future human explorers. But Russia isn't the only country planning to use nuclear reactors in space and other planets. NASA is also working on a nuclear power plant to be established in deep space, more specifically on the surface of the moon. SpaceX also plans to use nuclear energy on Mars when solar panels will not be able to work due to Mars storms, which last for many days. And SpaceX is also working on new propulsion systems. So, I think nuclear propulsion would probably be one of them. Now let's move forwards towards China. China had many exciting plans for space exploration. The country is expecting to build large nuclear power space shuttles that will allow for the mining of asteroids and the large-scale space exploration, reported by state-run media. These nuclear power space shuttles will allow China to send a large payload to its future Moon and Mars base in shorter time periods. These space shuttles may also enable space tourism to far planets of the solar system such as Jupiter, and even to Saturn's biggest and most special moon, Titan, where you may fly like a bird with just a pair of wings. China has the ambitious goal of becoming a global leader in space technology by 2045. According to the roadmap of space transportation of China, the country will improve its comprehensive launch capabilities and start to provide multiple commercial launch services. China endeavors to develop its own reusable space plane and rocket in the next 5 years. This reusable rocket will be Long March 8, which China is currently testing and developing. China also intends to make all of its launch vehicles reusable by 2030. If everything goes as planned, along March 9, China's first super heavy lift rocket will make its maiden flight by the same year. This Long March 9 will be capable of carrying the payload up to 150 tons. This rocket is tasked to be used for launching crewed missions to the Moon as well as likely unmanned missions to Mars. By 2035, China hopes to develop its first fully reusable super heavy lift launch vehicle, which will probably compete with SpaceX's Starship launch vehicle. China also aims to start providing commercial point-to-point suborbital flights on Earth by the same year. By 2040, China expects to build a new generation of rockets, including a nuclear-powered space shuttle, will be put into operation for the country's mega space projects, such as asteroid mining and a large space-based solar power station, which will send electricity back to Earth. At the end of the roadmap, China expects to become the world leader in space exploration. But, currently, both Russia and China are copying SpaceX's rocket technology in order to compete with private space organizations. Their future launch vehicles look extremely similar to SpaceX's launch vehicle. Private companies of China are trying to mimic SpaceX's Falcon 9 rocket. And about a few months ago, China's main state-owned rocket manufacturer, the China Academy of Launch Vehicle Technology, or just CALT, released a video of a concept of a fully reusable launch vehicle, which looks like the carbon copy of SpaceX's Starship launch vehicle. Russians are also working towards developing their first reusable methane rocket, which it turns out, also looks similar to the design of SpaceX's Falcon 9 rocket. The name of Russia's reusable rocket is Amur, which will be created for a given cost of the launch services at $22 million. Russia hopes to develop it by 2026. Both China and Russia actually have similar plans for the next 15 years. Currently, China is building its own space station, and hopes to complete it by late 2022. And Russia also plans to build and manage its own space station, which it aims to be launched into orbit by 2025 or 2030, which will cost at least $5 billion to set up using current technology. Russia and China also unveiled plans to build a joint space station on a lunar surface by 2035, and they call it the International Scientific Lunar Station. All these projects are exciting, but there is a problem, which is budget. Budget isn't the problem for China, as they had increased its space budget by about 300% in the last 5 years, and I believe that China will increase its space budget drastically over time. But budget is a problem for Russia. Currently, Russia's space budget is about 6% of which NASA is spending on space. So, Russia needs to greatly increase its budget for space, but they can still do much with this budget. If SpaceX can build the world's most powerful, cheapest, and fully reusable launch vehicle with a budget that is slightly more than Russia's, then Russia can also complete their space mega projects with this budget. All they need are great engineers similar to the ones who made Russia the first country to launch a satellite, man, woman, and a space station into space in the 1960s and 70s. So I hope you enjoyed this video. Comment down your views about this video, like and share this video, and subscribe to my channel. If you want to know why Elon Musk is building his own city starbase, watch this video. And to know how SpaceX will disrupt airline industry with its Starship, watch this video.